Dear learner, greetings of the day. Today I would like to tell you about the Poynting's theorem in this video lecture. So the Poynting theorem states that the net power flowing out of a given volume V is equal to the time rate of decrease in the energy stored within the volume V minus the ohmic losses. By looking at this picture, we have a volume and power is going in and power is going out from this port. As per the Poynting theorem, the total power which is going out of the volume is equal to the time rate of decrease in the energy stored in the electric field and the magnetic energy stored in the magnetic field minus the ohmic losses. The ohmic losses are also treated to be the ohmic power which is dissipated. Now, looking at the mathematical expression for the Poynting theorem is closed surface integral of E bar cross H bar dot ds bar equal to minus dou by dou t volume integral of 1 by 2 epsilon E square plus 1 by 2 mu H square dv minus volume integral sigma E square dv. We will see each and every term written in the mathematical expression. The left side term, surface integral E bar cross H bar dot ds bar indicates the total power leaving the volume, and minus dou by dou t stands for the time rate of decrease, and the volume integral of 1 by 2 epsilon E square plus 1 by 2 mu H square dv stands for the energy stored in electric and magnetic fields, and the volume integral sigma E square dv stands for the ohmic losses. And we will see the proof. We know that energy can be transported from one point to another point by means of electromagnetic waves. The rate of such energy transportation can be obtained from Maxwell's equations. So we have time varying Maxwell's equations from Faraday's law and as well as from Ampere's modified circuits law as del cross E bar equal to minus mu dou H bar by dou t, treating this one as equation one, and del cross H bar equal to sigma E bar plus epsilon dou E bar by dou t as equation number two. Now taking dot product on equation two with E bar gives us E bar dot del cross H bar equal to E bar dot sigma E bar plus epsilon dou E bar by dou t. And also simplifying this, we get E bar dot del cross H bar equal to sigma E square plus E bar dot epsilon dou E bar by dou t. But for any vector fields, A bar and B bar, so we have del dot A bar cross B bar equal to B bar dot del cross A bar minus A bar dot del cross B bar. Now, taking the term A bar dot del cross B bar towards left, we get del cross del dot A bar cross B bar plus A bar dot del cross B bar equal to B bar dot del cross A bar. Assuming that A bar is magnetic field H bar, B bar as electric field E bar, and applying this to the above vector identity, we get del dot H bar cross E bar plus H bar dot del cross E bar equal to E bar dot del cross H bar, treating this one as equation number three. But E bar dot del cross H bar equal to sigma E square plus E bar dot epsilon dou E bar by dou t, as we have already seen in the previous slide, and which is also equal to sigma E square plus epsilon by 2 dou E square by dou t, and this is the equation number four. Also, taking the dot product on equation one with H bar gives us H bar dot del cross E bar equal to H bar dot minus of mu dou H bar by dou t, and we get minus mu by 2 dou H square dou t, and we treat that one as equation number 5. Substituting equations 4 and 5 in equation 3, we get minus of del dot E bar cross H bar minus mu by 2 dou H square by dou t equal to sigma E square plus epsilon by 2 dou E square by dou t. Now, taking the mu by 2 dou H square by dou t term to the right side, we get minus of del dot E bar cross H bar equal to sigma e square plus epsilon by 2 dou e square by dou t plus mu by 2 dou h square by dou t. Multiplying the above expression with a negative sign on both sides, we get del dot e bar cross h bar equal to minus sigma e square minus half epsilon by 2 dou e square by dou t minus mu by 2 dou h square by dou t. And again simplifying that, we get del dot e bar cross h bar equal to minus sigma e square minus half, taking dou by dou t common, then we get 1 by 2 epsilon e square plus 1 by 2 mu h square. So taking the volume integral on both sides, we get volume integral del dot e bar cross h bar dot dv equal to minus dou by dou t volume integral of 1 by 2 epsilon e square plus 1 by 2 mu h square dv minus of volume integral sigma e square dv. And applying the divergence theorem on the left side of the above equation, we get closed surface integral e bar cross h bar dot ds bar equal to minus dou by dou t of volume integral 1 by 2 epsilon e square plus 1 by 2 mu h square dv minus of volume integral sigma e square dv. Hence, we proved that the net power flowing out of a given volume V is equal to the time rate of decrease in the energy stored in electric and magnetic field within the volume V minus the ohmic losses. Already we have seen this. So the total power leaving the volume will be equal to the time rate of decrease in energy stored in the electric and magnetic fields minus the ohmic losses. Also, the Poynting theorem says that the cross product of electric field and magnetic field at any point is a measure of the rate of energy flow per unit area at that point, that is P bar equal to E bar cross H bar watts per meter square. If you feel this video lecture is informative, please like and subscribe my channel for more technical content. Thank you.